Well, it's all about the adventures of Bonnie and Clyde at the Thomas Crane Public Library this month. As a noted historian and author, Christopher Daly, is making a presentation, True Crime on the Trail of Bonnie and Clyde. It's July 28th this month from 7 to 8:30 p.m., but he's here right now to give us a little preview. Chris, welcome.
Thank you.
Thanks
it's
for
good to be
over.
Here.
Yeah, appreciate it. Tell us a little bit about yourself. This is not the first time you've been here at Thomas Crane.
No, I've been here several times. I've somewhat of a lecture company, you might say. And I've been here for the Lincoln assassination. I did also the Kennedy assassination and one other that escapes me which one. But this coming month, we're going to be doing Bonnie and Clyde.
Okay. So your background, tell us a little bit about yourself.
I teach history at Silver Lake Regional down in Kingston. Mm-hmm. And my background as far as Bonnie and Clyde and all these other things is I've just been a history buff or a historian, you might say, for as long as I can remember. Mm. And the lectures are based on my interests, which seem to attract a lot of other people. And it's usually in the true crime area, you might say, obviously by the Lincoln assassination and the Kennedy assassination. So the next one I wanted to put out was Bonnie and Clyde because my wife and I were able to actually travel down into Texas, Louisiana, Oklahoma, and find a lot of these spots. And I developed a lecture based on that.
Okay. So why Bonnie and Clyde and why now?
Mm. A lot of people will say, why glorify these two? Mm. 12 people were murdered by the Barrow Gang. I should say Bonnie wasn't really involved in any of the murders, but she was along. And the reason isn't the murders or the... I think people are attracted to this because of the romantic aspect. That here you have two people. Bonnie was given many of opportunities just to leave Clyde, and she probably would have done maybe 5 or 6 years in prison, but she stuck with him knowing that the end would be them getting shot down, and that's what happened in Gibson, Louisiana. Hmm. 80 years ago, this May 23rd, 1934.
Okay, yeah. So that's the reason for the timing.
Yeah, it's I think the romantic aspect. Also, there were several ambushes set for them over the course of the few years that they were at large, and they miraculously escaped these ambushes several times, which kind of lends to an aspect that Clyde had this sixth sense about when the law was going to come, and they always shot their way out of it. So it has that kind of aspect too.
Okay. Were they married? Or was this
no, they weren't.
They were not married.
Okay. No, they were just boyfriend and girlfriend.
Okay.
And I guess you could call them common law, but I don't know if they had that in Texas.
And you actually followed in their footsteps.
Yeah, we went to a lot of the locations. We started in Gibson, Louisiana, where they were ambushed in 1934, discovered that there's an ambush museum run by none other than a fellow named Boots Hinton. His father was one of the deputies that actually shot them down in the ambush.
Okay.
And I spent about 2 hours banging his ear.
I bet, yeah.
And it was really marvelous talk with him. And then we went into Texas. Found a lot of the sites, the robberies, the hideouts, where they lived. Also, some of the banks that they robbed, some of those locations.
They're still in existence. Huh?
Yeah, a lot of them are. Wow. We actually found a little place in Kemp, Texas, called the Calaboose, where Bonnie was kept for a few nights. It's just nothing more than a brick jail cell out in the middle of a field. And while we were out there, a police car came up. And I thought, oh, great, we have mass plates and we're in Texas.
Yeah, right.
And it turns out the lady pulls up. It was a lady officer, and she looked over at that, and she said, that's cool, isn't it? And I thought to myself, well, okay, we're not going to be arrested.
Yeah, that's right.
And then she announces that she's also the mayor of Kemp, Texas, and told us several stories about when Bonnie was kept there and how the populace treated her and whatnot. So,
so you get some great.
We have a lot of little stories like that that will be in the lecture.
Yeah. What does the presentation here at the library involve? What will be?
Well, it's basically, it starts out with who were Bonnie and Clyde. You get a little biography of each of them. And what I try to do is give a little difference between what you've seen in the movies and the reality. The movies are very over-exaggerated. Some even have Bonnie taking part in the robberies, which she never did. And also, I'll go blow by blow with the major occurrences that happened, some of the ambushes that they escaped from, the robberies. And then at the end, we deal with how they were ambushed in Gippsland. And I've got footage of the area. There's actually a monument out there. And every year, they actually have a Bonnie and Clyde festival where they reenact the ambush.
No kidding.
Which,
okay.
I've never been to that, but this is the 80th anniversary, so it's probably going to be a big one.
Right. Look forward to it. Have a great presentation. Thanks for
coming. Thank you.
You're very welcome. And again, that is The True Crime on the Trail of Bonnie and Clyde with historian Christopher Daly. It's July 28th, 7 to 8:30 at the Thomas Crane Public Library.